Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline, and here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 29th of May.
PM Modi accuses Bengal CM Mamata Banerjee of giving space to infiltrators. Nawaz Sharif admits Pakistan violated peace agreement with India in 1999. And Russia is building relations with Afghanistan, says Putin on recognizing Taliban.
And now for all the details. Taking a jibe at opposition TMC leader and West Bengal CM Mamata Banerjee for opposing Citizenship Amendment Act, Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday said
that she wants to settle infiltrators in her state.
PM Modi, while addressing a rally in Mathurapur, said that infiltrators are grabbing the opportunities which are meant for the youth of the Bengal. He further said that the state government is attacking the constitution by snatching away the rights of the scheduled caste, scheduled tribes and other backward caste and giving them to Muslims.
Ab to TMC sarkar tushtikaran ke liye desh ke samvidhan par bhi khulkar hamla karne lagi hai. Hamare samvidhan ne दलितों पिछड़ों को आरक्षण दिया है लेकिन बंगाल में उस आरक्षण की खुली लूट हो रही है. मुसलमानों के फर्जी ओबीसी सर्टिफिकेट बनाए जा रहे हैं. ओबीसी समाज का हक छीनकर मुसलमानों को दिया जा रहा है. कोलकाता हाईकोर्ट ने ये फर्जी सर्टिफिकेट रद्द कर दिए. टीएमसी हाईकोर्ट का आदेश टाल नहीं सकती लेकिन मुसलमानों में झूठ बोल रही है.
However, slamming PM Modi, Congress leader Priyanka Gandhi said that the way BJP is running the country should be changed because their steps like demonetization and GST have caused a huge impact on small businesses. She further said that BJP's policy is to strengthen big billionaires by eliminating small businesses. The gigantic election exercise in India is ending with only a few days left for campaigning for the final phase of polling, which will be held on 1st of June and votes due to be counted on June 4th. Meanwhile, intense heat wave has prompted weather authorities in India to issue a red alert a day after some areas of New Delhi recorded highest temperature at around 50 degrees Celsius. Take a look.
India's weather department issued a red alert for several parts of the country's northwest on Wednesday, warning of a severe heat wave a day after parts of the capital New Delhi recorded their highest temperature ever at 49.9 degrees Celsius. A red alert implies a very high likelihood of people developing heat illness and heat stroke and calls for extreme care for vulnerable people.
Delhi aake aisa lag raha hai ki कैसे रहते होंगे लोग यहाँ पे. 48-49 डिग्री का टेम्परेचर जो कि भोपाल में हाईएस्ट हम 43 भी नहीं झेल पा रहे थे, बट यहाँ पे 49 डिग्री 48 डिग्री, मतलब मुझे लोगों की बड़ी चिंता हो रही. लोग बड़े सहज रूप से तो नहीं रह पा रहे होंगे, और जिसका मुझे लगता है बहुत बड़ा कारण है यहाँ पे जो एक तो कॉन्क्रीटीकरण हो गया है और दूसरा इंडस्ट्रीज अभी भी कार्बन इमिशन, मुझे लगता है जिस तरीके की गाड़ियाँ चल रही यहाँ पे कार्बन इमिशन बहुत ज़्यादा है यहाँ पे, जिसकी वजह से गर्मी दिल्ली में दिनों दिन बढ़ती जा रही है हर साल.
Meanwhile, several students in eastern Bihar states Shekhpura and Begusarai had to be rushed to hospitals after they fainted due to extreme temperatures in the region. They were given initial first aid and were in stable condition, doctors said.
अभी जो गर्मी का प्रकोप है, जिसका टेम्परेचर अभी बहुत हाई लेवल में जा रहा है, इसके चलते बच्चे लोग को परेशानी हो रही है. ये इलेक्ट्रोलाइट इंबैलेंस हो रहा है, उसके चलते ये लोग बच्चे को बेहोशी का चक्कर आना, उल्टी होना, ये सब लक्षण दिखाई दे रहा है.
Billions of people across Asia, including India's neighbor Pakistan, have also been experiencing a hotter summer this year. A trend scientists say has been worsened by human-driven climate change. Local residents in Jacobabad city were seen seeking respite under water pumps and in front of portable cooling units amid 47 to 48 degrees Celsius. The weather authorities have forecast the heat spell will continue till the first week of June.
Pakistan's former Prime Minister and PMLN Supremo Nawaz Sharif on Tuesday admitted that Islamabad violated the Lahore Agreement signed between India and Pakistan in 1999. Addressing a meeting of the PMLN General Council, where he assumed the presidency 6 years post his disqualification by the Supreme Court, Sharif said that violation was Pakistan's fault. A veiled reference to Pakistan's forced invasion in Kargil region led by then Army Chief General Pervez Musharraf. On May 28, 1998, Pakistan carried out 5 nuclear tests. After that, Vajpayee Sahab came here and made an agreement with us. But we violated that agreement. It was our fault, he said. The two neighbors, which have fought multiple wars, had signed the Lahore Agreement on 21st of February 1999, when India's then Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee went to Lahore with the goal of fostering peace and stability. However, shortly after the agreement, under the command of General Musharraf, Pakistani forces infiltrated into Kargil. A full-scale war erupted after Indian forces discovered the infiltration, which resulted in India's victory and ouster of Nawaz Sharif from office. Russian President Vladimir Putin on Tuesday emphasized on building ties with Taliban regime in Afghanistan and said that everybody knows about the problems people face in the country and only solution to that is to recognize the regime. Since Kabul fell to Taliban last year, the regime has been imposing severe restrictions on women and no country has formally recognized them. Putin further said that Moscow should take Afghanistan's opinion into account due to their control over Afghanistan. Putin's remarks came a day after the proposal to remove the Taliban from the list of banned organizations in Russia was discussed with the president of Iran.
В Афганистане есть проблемы, они безусловные, они все хорошо, всем хорошо известны. Вопрос, как выстраивать отношения с действующей властью, это другой вопрос. Но выстраивать как-то надо. Это же люди, которые контролируют страну, контролируют территорию страны. Они являются властью сегодня в Афганистане. Но надо исходить из реалий и соответствующим образом выстраивать отношения.
And Nepal presented a $14 billion US dollars budget on Tuesday for the next financial year beginning in mid-July after the main opposition party ended protest following government's assurance to probe corruption charges against the Home Minister. Finance Minister Barsha Manpun said internal revenue and foreign grants would contribute $9.8 billion to the expenditure and the deficit would be met largely through internal loans and foreign borrowings. The policies proposed in the budget will help achieve 6% economic growth next year, he added. Nepal's economy is expected to grow by 3.9% in the current year. However, former Finance Minister Prakash Charan Mehet of the opposition Nepali Congress Party said that the rise in internal borrowings would make funds scarce for the private sector and job creation. The growth target will not be achieved and there are no concrete programs for priority sectors like agriculture, tourism and energy. And hours after Sri Lankan President Ranil Wickremesinghe's UNP General Secretary Palitha Range Bandara called for delaying elections by 2 years through a referendum, citing ongoing economic reforms, the government has distanced itself from his remarks. Local media reported, answering a media query, Sri Lanka's Labour Minister Manusha Nanayakara said political parties represented in parliament are free to give proposal, but it will be the government which will have to make a final decision. He said while Wickremesinghe is politically associated with the UNP, the president remains an independent person and they reiterated the comments from the Bandara did not represent the government's stand. Notably, the presidential election is due by October 2024. However, incumbent President Wickremesinghe has yet to declare his candidature for the polls. Hundreds of locals took part in the annual cleaning and fishing festival at the famous Panzat Nag Spring in Jammu and Kashmir recently. The annual festival held in the last week of May not only fosters community spirit but also aids in the spring's maintenance for the year ahead. Residents, including young children, carried wicker baskets and waded through chest-deep waters in the spring, diligently cleaning it and also fishing. A resident said it's a practice they have inherited from their ancestors, which combines tradition with environmentalism.
पुराने लोगों की परंपरा है, जो हमारे बुजुर्ग लोग हैं उन्होंने परंपरा रखा है, यहाँ इस इन तीन चश्मों को सफाई की जाए और पूरे साल में पानी अच्छी तरह से चल जाए, वो खेती बाड़ी का काम अच्छी तरह से हो जाए, पानी जाए खेतों में, इसलिए परंपरा हमने रखा है और लोग आते हैं जोश दर जोश।
Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.